biology session, we are discussing our new lesson, that is respiration in organisms. In this same lesson, already we have learned about some points. We have discussed about the cellular respiration. Also, we have discussed about the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Okay. So today, in this same lesson, we will move for the next point, that is lesson number 4, breathing. Okay. So let's discuss what is mean by breathing. So for that, I will tell you one activity that you have to perform with me. You have to sit straight and you have to just hold your nostrils for a while. Okay. So after holding this nostril, or we cannot hold our nostrils for a long period of the time. Okay. Why? And if you do like that, then we are feeling the suffocation. Why is it happen? Because with the help of these nostrils, we are doing one process, and that is nothing but what? Breathing. Okay? So throughout our life, we are continuously doing this breathing process. So this breathing process is also very important for the survival of a living organism. Okay? So what is in the exactly breathing? What happens in the breathing? So during the breathing, we inhale and exhale the air. But during the inhalation of the air, what we are doing? So when we are doing the breathing process, that time when we are taking the oxygen rich air inside the body, then that process is called as what? Inhalation. That process is called as what? Inhalation. Okay. And opposite to that, when we are exhale out the air, and that exhale out air is rich in carbon dioxide, and that process is called as what? Exhalation. That process is called as exhalation. Okay. So this inhalation and the exhalation together we forms the breathing. Okay. What is mean by the inhalation? When we breathe in, that time we are breathing the oxygen rich air, and that process is called as inhalation. Opposite to that, when we exhale the air which is rich in carbon dioxide, that process is called as what? Exhalation. Okay. So this inhalation and exhalation we are performing throughout our life, and with the help of that we can survive properly. So the number of times we breathe, okay, the number of times we breathe per minute, that is called as what? Breathing rate. That process or that number is called as what? Breathing rate. Okay. So breathing rate means what? The number of times we breathe during 1 minute, or per minute, how much time we are doing the breathing process, that rate is called as what? Breathing rate. Okay. So usually, how to count this breathing rate? Breathing rate means what? One inhalation followed by the one exhalation, then it forms the one breathe. Okay. So how you will count your breathing rate? What is mean by the breathing rate? How much time you are breathing per minute? It is called as breathing rate. But how you have to count your breathing? One inhalation and one exhalation forms the one breathe. Okay. So in this way, you can also find out your breathing rate. Normally, an average adult person is having 15 to 18 breaths per minute. Okay. 15 to 18 breaths per minute. But when we are having heavy exercise, or whenever we are performing physical activities, then this breathing rate gets increased 25 times per minute. Okay. It gets increased. 25 per minute. Okay, so this is all about what? Breathing rate. So generally we are performing this breathing process every day, but whenever we are performing that, we are not such aware that we are doing the breathing, but we are having any physical activity, or we are doing some hard work, then we are feeling that yes, we are performing this breathing process. When we are sleeping, that time also we are performing the breathing. Okay. So whenever we are in the rest position, that time our body doesn't require the more amount of the oxygen, or the doesn't require the more amount of the energy. That is the reason that time the breathing rate is slow, or the normal, we can say that. Generally when we are sleeping, that time the breathing rate is quite low, because that time our body doesn't perform any work. Only the internal organs are performing their work. So they require the energy, but not in a great amount. But opposite to that, when we are having very physical activity, very high physical activity, we are doing exercise, running, jumping, okay, that time we require the more amount of the energy, and to fulfill that more amount of the energy, we require the more amount of the oxygen, and to take that more amount of the oxygen, we started to do the breathing very fast, and that time our breathing rate will increase. Okay, so now you understood why we are doing the breathing after the breathing faster when we are running, because that time our need of the oxygen in our body is more, and to take the more amount of the oxygen, we take the long breath and the fast breaths also. Okay, so this is all about breathing. Now we will move for the next point, that is how exactly we are really breathing. How do we breathe? Okay, so let's discuss which are the organs which help us to do the breathing process. So as we know, we are doing the breathing process with the help of our nostrils. Okay, so with the help of our nostrils, we are taking the oxygen rich air inside. Through the nostrils, the air reaches to this nasal passage. Okay, with the help of the nostrils, we are taking inside air. That air goes into the nasal passage. From this nasal passage, the air comes into this trachea, or this trachea is also called as windpipe. Okay, so from this nasal passage, this air comes into the trachea, and through the trachea, the air goes into the lungs. Okay, the air goes into the lungs. Very important, this trachea is also called as what? Windpipe. So from the nostril, air comes into the nasal passage. Through the nasal passage, with the help of the trachea, the air comes into the lungs. Okay, and so these lungs are having so many branches inside. With the help of the branches, the air can get transported, or from that branches, the oxygen can get absorbed and get transported to the different body parts. Okay, so this is about what breathing organs. Also, this in the breathing system, or also in this respiration system, we can see these ribs. So these lungs are covered with the ribs, and they are situated in the chest cavity. Okay, so the lungs can get protected with the help of the rib cage. Along with this rib cage and the lungs, we can see here the one muscular sheath. Okay, so there is one muscular sheath at the base of the lungs, and that muscular sheath is called as what? Diaphragm. Okay, that muscular sheath is called as diaphragm. So along with all these body parts, or along with these all respiratory organs, we are performing the respiration process. But let's see how exactly we are performing the respiration process. So when we inhale the air, that time what happens? When we inhale the air, that time these ribs curves. Here you can see that. That time these ribs curves up and outward. Okay, these ribs curves up and outward. While this diaphragm goes to the downside. Okay, this diaphragm moves downside. Okay, why is it happens like this? Because of this upward and the outward position, and the diaphragm goes downward, what happens? The area is getting increased, and we can take the maximum oxygen inside. The maximum oxygen can enter inside when it happens during the inhalation. But when we are doing the exhalation, that time what happens? These ribs moves downward and inward, and this diaphragm comes to its former position. The diaphragm comes to its normal position, and because of that, the area gets decreased, and because of that, the carbon dioxide rich air is get pushed out. Okay, so in this way we are doing the inhalation and exhalation. When we are doing inhalation, ribs become outward and upward. While we are doing exhalation, that time ribs becomes inward and downward. So that is the reason when we are performing this breathing process, we can feel the movement in our abdominal cavity. If you touch my abdominal cavity, then you can feel the up and down movements are happens in our body. That is because of these movements of the rib cage. Okay, so this is about what? How do we breathe? So with the help of all these respiratory organs, we are performing the respiration process. Very important, as we know, the smoking is very harmful for the human being. So if we come in the contact of the smoker, if the someone is doing the smoking and if we breathe in that air, then also it is very hazardous, very dangerous to our lungs. So the smoking can affect our lungs. So one should avoid the smoking. also very important thing is nasal passage behind the hair. Okay, so whenever we are doing the breathing, the air is not pure. There are so many foreign materials, foreign particles are there, dust particles are which are present in the air. So when we are doing the breathing, that foreign particles or the dust particles enter in our nose and get entangled or get trapped into the nasal hairs. Okay, into the nasal hair. But sometimes what happens, they can pass this nasal hair and come into the lining of this nasal cavity. Okay, and that is time when that time we are doing the sneezing. And when we are doing the sneezing, that time that foreign particle or the dust particles comes out, and then again we can take the dust free or the foreign particle free air. Okay, now you understand how we are doing the sneezing. When any dust particle or any foreign particles get passed through the air and comes into this lining of the nasal cavity, then it started to irritate it and to throw out it from our body. We sneeze out, and with the help of that sneezing, we are throwing out that foreign particles. Okay, and that is the reason it is very important. Whenever we are sneezing, we can throw out the so many droplets are also coming out with our sneezing, and that is the reason we have to cover our nose and the mouth whenever we are coughing and sneezing, because with the help of the droplets, so many germs are also coming out and it will get spread into the air. Okay, so nowadays this is the time that we have to think about all these things. We should take care of all these small small things. Okay, so this is all about how do we breathe. But now the next one is that exactly what we breathe out. Okay, so the structure of this human respiratory system already you have brought in your biology notebook. So this model you can perform at your home also with the help of the activity number 10.5 given in your textbook. Page number is 113. So with the help of that you can make the model of the respiratory system also. Now we will move for the next point from the same lesson, that we will discuss about what do we breathe out. Okay, we'll discuss about what do we breathe out. What do we breathe out? Okay. So in the beginning of the lesson, we have discussed that when we inhale the air, we are taking the oxygen rich air. While we exhale the air, that time we are exhale out the carbon dioxide rich air. Okay. So to perform that or to explain that, we are having one activity. That activity you can see in the video how it is in that. Then one test tube is there. In that test tube, we have taken the lime water and we have to blow the air in that lime water. Initially before blowing the air into the lime water, the color of the lime water is normal, like the normal water. But when you blow the air, that time what happens? The color of the lime water get changed into the milky white. Okay, into what? Milky white. And that shows us what? When we are breathing out, we are throwing out the carbon dioxide. Because when the lime water comes in the contact of carbon dioxide, then it becomes milky white. Okay, it becomes milky white. Okay, so that is the confirmatory test. When the lime water comes in the contact of carbon dioxide, lime water plus carbon dioxide, then it becomes what? Milky white. Okay. So that is the reason from this experiment what we can say, that we can breathe out the carbon dioxide. But what is the exact amount of the carbon dioxide when we are performing the inhalation and exhalation? So as we know, the air is a mixture of the different gases. So when we are performing the inhalation process, we are telling that we are taking the oxygen rich air. But not like that only we are taking the oxygen rich air, along with the oxygen we are taking the some amount of carbon dioxide also. And when we are exhaling out air, that time we are throwing the carbon dioxide. Along with that carbon dioxide, we are throwing out little amount of the oxygen also. Okay. So let's see what is the amount of the carbon dioxide during the inhalation and exhalation, and what is the amount of the oxygen during the inhalation and the exhalation. So let's see the amount of the oxygen, how much it get inhale and exhale during the process of breathing. We can say that when we inhale the air, that time we are taking the 21% of oxygen. Okay. When we inhale the air, that time we are taking 21% oxygen, and we along with the oxygen we can take inside 0.04% of carbon dioxide. Okay. So proportion of the different gases to the gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen during inhalation and the exhalation. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about breathing. Also we have discussed about how do we breathe, and also we have discussed that what do we breathe out. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video for the discussion of the next point, and for today.